Hey, come on in.
You want to follow on? Check out this new 3D camera that I just got.
So, inside this box, we got a brand new Zivid 3D camera, and we got everything else that we need to get started. And today we also have a couple of parts that we'd like to look at. We're gonna see if we can take some good 3D images of this. Today, I'm going to use the Zivid One Plus Small, and it's optimal for taking images of small scenes and small objects. So on the back of the Zivid One Plus camera, I've connected the power cable and I've connected the USB cable that goes into my PC. I'm going to set it up with a small angle onto the surface to avoid reflections from the background. Before we can start taking pictures with the Zivid One Plus camera, we have to make sure that our PC is up to date and meets the requirements that we need to run point clouds on it. The Zivid One Plus cameras, they run on Windows environments and Linux environments. They use the GPU to process data. So it's important to make sure that the GPU is up to date before we get started. And you can find more information about this in the Zivid knowledge base. Zivid Studio is a graphical user interface that we use to evaluate and capture point clouds. And you can find the installer for your environment in the download section on Zivid.com. In Zivid Studio, we have the main view and we also have the control panel. And in the main view, you can see the point cloud either with color or just texture. And you can see the 2D color map or you can see the depth map. In the control panel on the top right, you can see which cameras are available. So in the control panel, there's two ways of basically using the camera. One is to use it in the manual mode where you specify all the parameters for exposure and filters yourself, or you can use the new assisted mode, which will help you determine what settings you should use for your scene. Let's take a look at the workflow of taking your first point cloud. Connect your camera, and then you specify which mode you want to work in. And I like to start off with assisted mode. I specify a certain amount of time that I want the camera to capture point cloud with. We click Analyze and Capture, and now the camera will go into two phases. First, it will do a learning phase, where it basically analyzes the scene and tries to figure out what can I do to get the best possible point cloud out of this. And then second, it will capture that point cloud. Now that I have a point cloud, I can take those settings back into manual mode and further tweak them if I would like to. You can tick off a couple of the frames that you're not interested in using, or you can play further with the filters or tweak some of the exposure values. Now that we've found the optimal settings for our scene, we can then take those settings and use them in the SDK when we develop our final application.